He had to act fast. Time was running out on him. He meant to marry Donna. Not all the insurance companies in the world could stop him. But he had to be a free man, first. He had to find out who was after him, who wanted him out of the way and what. If he was wrong about Jackson, he was dead. Really dead. Unable to sit still, he got out of his chair and walked around the little office. The piled cans of motor oil, the red tires, the pyramid of new batteries. He studied the calendar girl hanging on the wall beside the desk, his desk pen set in cigarette lighter. He walked around the room again. Now he was looking at the Autolite batteries. That made him remember Mrs. Conover on Hamilton Avenue and the night he'd installed an Autolite in her car. He needed to see that woman very badly. But what the hell excuse could he give for barging in on her unannounced? It had to be a good one. Or did it? After all, if Jackson was as guilty as he hoped, she might be in this up to her ears. From what Donna had said, she knew Jackson. Suppose she had fingered him for those killers in the Cadillac last December? Certainly, she wanted no trouble from the police. He reached for the telephone. After a moment, he heard her voice. Dan Kinnick, Mrs. Conover. You know, the garage man. Oh, Dan. Yes, of course. What is it? I was wondering if you could help me. Why, I suppose so. If I can, that is. Wariness was in her voice, but that might be natural. You remember the night I brought the battery to you? Back in December? Well, on my way home, a man took a shot at me. Yes, that's right. With a revolver. He tried to kill me. Oh, that's terrible. Awful. Who let him, but what can I do? The quiver was there. Now. He could catch it. Maybe the rich bitch was a little worried. He had to be careful. One slip up and he was finished. He needed time to think. Might I come over this evening for a little talk? I don't want to blab my suspicions over the phone. For all I know, my line may be tapped. The police were called in, you understand. Tonight? Why, I'm not doing anything, going anywhere. I guess you could come over, yes. Thank you, Mrs. Conover. Shall I make it around 9? 9 will be perfect. Goodbye, Mrs. Conover.